trice. Real name, no gimmicks.
On this mini episode of Should You Hack, we're going to be looking at the IBM Model F keyboard, which, in case you didn't know, is the greatest keyboard of all time. Now, IBM, in their infinite 80s wisdom, came up with this great idea where if you, as the end user, wanted to do something wild, like take all your keycaps off and clean underneath it because you have a cat that likes to lay on your keyboard all day, collects hair and stuff, right? So you take all the keycaps off with your fancy keycap puller and you take the space bar off, you know, because that's one of the keys you'd like to clean under. You clean it out, vacuum it up, blow it out, whatever you're going to do. And then you realize you can't actually put the space bar back on. There are two metal rods on each side of the space bar underneath the plastic of the keyboards. And there are these tabs on the space bar right here. And you need to hook them into the metal rods that are underneath the keyboard. So in order to do that, you need to completely disassemble the keyboard and then pretty much make it like a sandwich where, like, you know, hook it under there and then put the rest of the keyboard back together while the space bar is still hooked in. At least that's my theory, because I have found no videos on YouTube or anywhere else on the internet of anyone actually doing this. So I thought, wow, how can I do this without taking the keyboard apart? Because I really don't want to take it apart because it's really old, it's from the 80s, and the plastic might be really brittle. If I break something, I mean, good luck finding a replacement part, right? So I figured there's gotta be an easier way. So I found a forum post that some dude just like drilled a hole right in the side of the plastic, hooked some floss on the rod and yanked it up. So that way the tabs can actually, you know, get on there. People say it seems to work. So let's give it a go.
Shame on the nigga who tried to run game on a nigga who's buck wild with the trigger. Shame on a nigga who tried to run game on a nigga who's bucks our fuck ass up. Yo, hut one, hut two, hut three, hut. Old dirty bastard, live and uncut. Styles unbreakable, shatterproof. To the young youth, you wanna get gun? Shoot, blah. How you like me now? Don't fuck the style. Ruthless, wow. Do you wanna get your teeth knocked the fuck out? Wanna get on it like
this is so fucking sketchy. Oh my god. Hit me with the major, the damage, my clan understand it be flavor. Alright. It's in there, but see the problem right here, if you press on this side, it just lifts it up, and this side just lifts it up, not stable. Alright, so that's the issue we were trying to fix. Now let's see how well this works. It's not working. That's great.
Well, that didn't work out at all. So I'm gonna try doing it what I think would be the proper way, and that's just taking the whole keyboard apart and like fishing the hook through the plastic. So let's go do that. What do you do? How the fuck does this get taken apart? I don't see any screws on here at all. Does it like, does this slide out? After doing a bit more research, I'm not gonna do this. As far as I can tell, I found one video online where a guy did it, but he skipped this part. He completely skipped the one part that I'm stuck on. I read the comments and someone was doing the same thing I'm doing, and he was like, hey, what did you do here? And the guy was like, oh, well, you just take a hammer and a flathead screwdriver and just chisel it out. And I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna risk breaking this thing. So one more idea that might work. Alright, this might be the dumbest thing I could do. I'm gonna yank this thing, I'm gonna put a decent amount of pressure on it, and then I'm gonna try just slamming it down and see if it catches. Wait, is that? Oh. Check it out, this is stable now. It's lifting this part up as I push it down, but this isn't. Oh shit, I need to floss this one now. So now, I'm just gonna wrap it around here and slam it. Holy shit. God, IBM, you're so fucking dumb. Why did you design a keyboard like this?
Wow, what an adventure we've had today, huh? Should you hack your IBM Model F with a drill and some dental floss? Well, I'm gonna say yeah, it sure beats having a wobbly space bar or not being able to clean your keyboard properly or even, you know, breaking it potentially by taking it apart. And you know you'd break it. You'd definitely break it. So that's all I got. Thanks for watching and tune in next time when I, you know, do something else in front of a camera.
I'm fucking your hoe. I'm fucking your hoe.